Hey, happy Thursday, people. Last time we talked, I was making carne asada, so as promised, I thawed out both the carne asada, the beef, and some chicken last night because I didn't know what the missus was going to want for Cinco de Mayo, so we ended up going with the beef, so can't let this chicken go to waste. So we're going to be doing some pollo asada, which is chicken asada. Which that company Pillarcitas, and I left a link in my last video, she does a marinade for both chicken, beef, shrimp, and there's like a fajita one and just a ton of great spices. You guys give it a try. I know it's readily available on the West Coast. I think you can order through their website. But so yeah, for today we got pollo asada, and that's how I usually do it. Is I'll get my chicken and my beef and I cut it all up, and then this is chicken breast filleted out to smaller pieces so they don't take a super long time to cook. But and then I'll marinate it, and then after a day or so in the fridge, I just freeze it, and then I can go to the freezer, pull it out when I want. I think this was put up yeah, a long time ago. Anyway, June 17th of last year, I put this up in the freezer. So, all right, well, let's get started. So you guys didn't really think I was going to barbecue on that propane barbecue, did you? That was just a teaser. Why miss an opportunity to make a fatwood fire with little oak as a base? Today we're going to do something a little different. We're going to actually use some charcoal briquettes. So it's another little experiment I haven't tried yet. I did do some homemade charcoal, but let's get this going here. We'll let that get going, and once we get some decent fire going in there, we'll put those briquettes on there, let those get hot, and then we'll throw that grill on and cook that chicken. So yeah, we used to pack in that little Weber barbecue that I showed earlier, a little propane barbecue to the races, and then we did tailgaters and stuff. But I think I found my new buddy here. Got the coals on there. They're starting to pop off, you can see that. So had to switch to the phone here instead of dealing with a GoPro. But forgot to mention, Nathan 4071, best ferro rods ever and a high-speed striker. I didn't buy the striker. I had a, from my lathe, I had a lathe bit that I used, and these are kind of my backwoods handles that I made. These are the first ferro rods that I got from Nathan. And then he was kind enough to play Santa Nathan for me for Christmas and gave me a beast, which I love, and a striker. But I use this one a lot in the backyard and when I'm doing a barbecue and stuff. Forgot to mention too, when you're working with stoves and this, especially this little grill here, the pocket bellows works out really nice. In fact, that I'd highly recommend a pocket bellows for anybody that's doing a stove or outdoor stove. You know, prevents you from having to lean over and blow on that fire and gets it done. Also, wanted to show you guys my my camera setup today. There's my GoPro mounted to my to an axe that I keep here in the backyard, and then mounted to, I've had this Ultra Pod for probably 20 years. Really great. They sell them at Camp Moore, I think is where I got mine. There's a bunch of sites. Amazon probably sells them now, but what a great tripod. It's a tripod, and then it's it clamps onto like a post or a tree limb or whatever, but what a great setup. So let's, I'll let these coals get all the way done and come back. We'll do some cooking. Okay, so here's what we got going. Got those coals on there. Those turned out nicely. There's probably, I don't know, maybe a dozen in there for this little thing. I like to heat up my grill. I usually just take a piece of tin foil, knock off the top layer, and I like leaving the rest of that on there, much like cast iron, it starts to build up a seasoning, so right, that won't slide off there either, right? Look at that. Well, I suppose if you got really physical with it. So let's get some of this chicken on here, because I'm getting hungry, and I don't want this video to be 2 hours long. All right. Maybe I should have cooked some of this last night. There's a lot of chicken in this bag. By the time we're done, I guess somebody will want me to mail them some, huh? Just kidding. There you go. Another piece here. Nothing fancy. Just chicken breasts from either Sam's Club or Costco. And then I fillet them and cut them into manageable pieces. It can be tossed about on the grill during the cooking process. Much easier to deal with. That one's a big one there. Anyway, so we'll come back in a little bit when that starts to get cooked a little better. Okay, so here's where we're at. I pulled the first bit off. There you go. That's ready to be chopped up and made tacos out of. And over here we've got, I did add, right? No jokes about the bandage on the finger. If you like knives, axes, and sharp things, and making fires, you're gonna cut yourself. So we're just gonna leave that alone. I did add a little bit of seasoned oak to this because I like a charred. Even on the last batch, I added a little wood in the end, but I like the charred effect on the meat, just like last night with the carne asada. So yeah, we'll come back and check in on this when we get a little further along, and then we'll have a taco. Okay, so finished up that last little bit of chicken. Take a look at that. That's let me just try one here. That is pretty good. So let's what we want to do is we want to throw a couple tortillas on here, let those get warm, and then we're just going to take some of that chicken and chop it up. Tells you that you can't put an edge on a $9 Tractor Supply axe, tell them to send me their axe. That is like the third time I've done that. Yeah, stupid. I know. Should learn how to use my gloves every time, huh? Alright, so we got our tortillas heating up here. You want those to get good and soft. And then got us a plate, got some salsa here. What else? We got a, can't have tacos without a jalapeno. Can't have a jalapeno. Anyway, so there we go. So let's take, yeah, those are turning out. Okay, we'll take us a tortilla, a couple tortillas. We're going to put some meat on there. Just like that. Yeah, chicken. And I've got to have some salsa. Yep. And okay, I said yep. I sound like Ron and John, don't I? Yep. A little bit of lettuce. I usually put chopped up onion on my beef, but a little bit of lettuce. And then, I was gonna put, yeah. Right, is that me? Yeah, I was gonna put cheese on them, but this is for my friend Harry. I know how you are about cheese, Harry. So, here we go. Bon appetit. I mean, is it chili? That was close. I know bon appetit is French and all, but between all the cooking and cutting and stuff and my finger, didn't have time to look up what bon appetit was in Spanish. So, hope you enjoyed the video. The little barbecue thing works great. Happy Cinco Seis de Mayo. Yeah, happy 6th of May. So, thanks for tagging along and checking out the video. See you guys tomorrow. Fatwood Friday. I guess I wasn't done. Those are good tacos. Tacos.